साथियों, आप सुन रहे हैं आपका अपना ऑनलाइन इंटरनेशनल रेडियो स्टेशन यानी कि BSSS रिदम, मेरे यानी आरजे श्रुति के साथ। वेल दोस्तों, आज का दिन बड़ा ही खास है क्योंकि आज का शो भी बहुत खास है। अब भाई, शो इतना खास इसलिए है क्योंकि आज यानी कि 28th of February इज सेलिब्रेटेड एज नेशनल साइंस डे। एंड टू मेक दिस डे मोर स्पेशल, वी हैव अ वेरी रेनाउंड पर्सनैलिटी अमंगस्ट अस टुडे इन Rhythm Studio. I have Mr. Sayyam Srivastava amongst us. Welcome, sir.
Thank you for having me here.
Okay. So, sir, this is the very first time we are interacting with you. Our listeners are listening you for the first time. So, I want you to tell something about yourself.
Well, first of all, to all the listeners, a very hearty namaste and a good afternoon to each one of you. First of all, I would like to introduce me as a person in front of all of you. Basically, in the field of, in the genre of science, I had been a scientist from past 7 or 8 years.
Okay.
Alongside, I had been the onboard director for NASA for some certain projects. Those were given for the Central India. Provided the one of the project was Cassini Scientist for a Day, which I had mooted solely. And it was basically the brainchild of one of the most renowned scientists under whom I worked. Alongside, I have had done some works on the field of cosmology, the high energy astrophysics, and also in the field of black holes. Talking about the local place of Bhopal in Madhya Pradesh, I'd been a lecturer at Regional Science Center, and I have also given a number of lectures in some certain universities and schools all around Central India. Apart of that, I started with an astronomical organization of mine that was in the year of 2009 as an aftermath of the International Year of Astronomy. So, that organization, the Sky Trackers and Astronomical Researchers Club, I am the director of the club at present also. Oh, so, it has been almost 10 years that I have had been the director of the club in the certain position.
Wonderful.
So, all these certain projects internationally, those are under the European Southern Organization and also under the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, are well managed by me.
Okay.
So, all the astronomical ventures that you might have an interest into, so you can just get into the details and you can ask me further whatever it is. And once again, wishing all the audience a very happy National Science Day.
Wow. So, you are basically into astronomy or astrophysics,
yeah,
right?
Indeed.
Yeah. So, sir, what we know is that scientists basically do research work in some particular field. They explore a particular field. So, are you into this astronomy, astrophysics? Is it?
Yeah, I am.
Okay. Sir, I would like to know one thing, that science is everywhere, right?
जी.
Like, science ke bina almost aadhi cheeze to impossible si ho jati hain. So, why do we hear people asking among themselves that whether science is boon or ban? Like, are they doubting science?
Exactly. They are not doubting science, I would say. They are actually maintaining the rhetoric that has been throughout the years. Actually, logo ke man mein a concept hota hai ki har cheez ke do pehlu hote hai. There are always the twin aspect to anything that exists outside in the world. So, there is also a positive aspect, there is also a negative aspect. So, I won't say that people are doubting science per se, but you know, whenever you study something, whenever you get into some details, to apan uske limitations bhi jante hain, apan uski positivity bhi jante hain. So, we come out with the drawbacks as well. So, even in the field of science, concomitantly, that is the truth. The people want to know the other side of this as well, because you know, when we discovered atom bombs, we can see today aaj hamare sath kya ho raha hai ki nuclear bombs jo countries hai, they are on the verge of fighting each other. So people want to know ki agar hum pe kal ko attack hota hai, so what kind of repercussions can we have, what kind of like uske kya wo honge, harmful effects honge hamare upar. So it is like the basic tendency of people to ask and to question, and if we do not question it the other way around, to jo curiosity hai wo kahin na kahin mar jayegi. So that is like very much needed.
Right. Yeah. Sir, aaj Science Day hai, 28th of February. So
exactly.
Would you like to say something to our listeners regarding Science Day?
Exactly. Well, National Science Day has been celebrated as an epitome for Dr. C.V. Raman, the much renowned scientist jo hamare India se the, jinhe Nobel Prize mila tha physics mein in the year of 1928 for Raman effect. So basically, Science Day is a moment for all of us to cherish the science. Aaj ke date mein ye ho gaya hai ki hum log itne busy ho chuke hain hamare aaspas ki cheezon se that we are not actually engaged, or we are not actually getting into into the deeper questions of what is science. Science is all around us.
Yes.
So even the kids, they are on their mobile phones, but they are not actually getting into the deeper roots of science. They're not eventually getting into somewhere ki aas paas aap prakriti mein dekhe, har jagah dekhe. Sunset hota hai, sunrise hota hai. After a rain shower, you get a beautiful rainbow. So, you know, Science Day is a moment for all of us to actually cherish all the wonders of science which are around us and all the wonders of physics which are around us. So you can actually get into the much more details around you. You can scrutinize better whatever there is within the nature. So National Science Day is a moment ki jab hum usse cherish kar sake, hum science ko ek aur behtar tarike se jaan sake, and we can actually come across more different fields of science. We can come out across through more innovations. To hum pata laga sakte hain ki science mein kya chal raha hai, hamare aas pass nature mein kya ho raha hai, and eventually aajkal ke jo youth hai, jo generation hai, jinhe hum dekh sakte hain, so they are like more bewildered by the Instagram or social media. So at the same time us social media mein bhi hum jaake dekhen ki scientific researches kya hui hai. I hardly doubt ki how many of you might have like subscribed to NASA or to European Southern Observatory. So you know, this is also an opportunity for all of us to actually subscribe some new channels like National Geographic and Discovery Channel. We can even eventually come out with something better on this National Science Day, and also the young ones who are like in their pre-elementary schooling and all. So we can actually come out with different fields and different methods to actually teach them and train them, and we can actually make them acknowledge that better there is also National Science Day of this sort. So this can like work wonders for all of us to become aware of the science around us.
तो आप ये कहना चाह रहे basically कि जो आज का youth है वो बाहर अगर nature में जाता है तो देखता जरूर है सब, उसकी beauty को अच्छे से perceive करता है, but then वो उसको क्लिक करके, पिक्चर क्लिक करके सोशल नेटवर्किंग साइट्स पे अपलोड करता है और सबको दिखाना चाहता है. ना कि ये कि वो उसकी डेप्थ में जाए और समझे कि
जो भी है उसके नीचे हम अपना एक प्यारा सा टाइटल लगा देते हैं, वी हैव अ गुड सिंबल और अ लोगो दैट दे सेंड दिस फोटोग्राफी. सो इवेंचुअली इफ वी डू सम होमवर्क एंड इफ वी कम आउट विद लाइक व्हाई द प्रोसेस इज हैपनिंग, व्हाई दिस थिंग इज हैपनिंग, जैसे वी सी अ कोकून एंड वी कैन एक्चुअली कम आउट की व्हाट रिसाइड्स इनसाइड अ कोकून, how a butterfly is formed and what are the processes that goes into making a cocoon. We come across hibiscus, we come across anaphids. So these are like flowers. But aap logo ko lag raha hoga ki main kafi alien language ka use kar raha hu, but these are the flowers that we see in the everyday life. So we have to actually come across these things and we have to actually go through their lifestyle and what scientific development they undergo. So this National Science Day provides us with such an opportunity that you can actually contemplate and go within deeper in yourself, and you can come across the science and you can actually be a better, I would say, aware person, not a better scientific person, but a better aware person.
Okay. Sir, जैसे हर बार साइंस डे की कुछ ना कुछ थीम होती है, तो इस बार की जो थीम है वो है साइंस फॉर द पीपल एंड पीपल फॉर द साइंस. सो वुड यू लाइक टू कमेंट ऑन दिस?
Well, there can be a no better theme for the National Science Day that I see. Because I tell you something. See, I have been basically an astronomer, and in the field of science, I would say that science is born with man. You know, सबसे पहले the early man, the cavemen, the Neanderthals, and the hominins, the hominids. उन्होंने बैठ के पत्थर घसे, एंड दे केम आउट विद द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ फायर. यू नो, हैड द फायर नॉट बीन देयर, वी वुड हैव been nowhere in this 21st century. So basically these hominins, and they came out with the method of they discovered the fire. So basically usme pura physics tha. They actually came across the concept of friction without even realizing that.
Ki
do cheezon ko aap ghisoge to wo garam hoke the fire would be made eventually. So you know, the science, I would say, is a primordial field. When I say primordial, science has been born with man. Vyakti ka jo sabse, I would say, the speciality of a man is that he has to question. The curiosity is within a man. तो जब वो क्वेश्चन करते हैं, सो दे कम अक्रॉस द फील्ड ऑफ साइंस. साइंस इज ऑल अबाउट क्वेश्चनिंग योर नेचर. तो जो इनिशियल मैन थे, द केव मैन थे, दे केम अक्रॉस सो मेनी डिस्कवरीज, दे केम अक्रॉस फायर, दे केम अक्रॉस व्हील, एंड दे अंडरस्टूड, ओके, दिस इज साइंस. दे लुक्ड इनटू द नाइट स्काई एंड दे अंडरस्टूड दोज आर सर्टेन पैटर्न्स, दोज आर द कॉन्स्टिलेशंस, एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम द कॉन्स्टिलेशंस, दोज आर लाइक सर्टेन मूवमेंट ऑफ द सन एंड द मून. सो सबसे पुराने ग्रीक लोग थे, ग्रीक के बाद फिर जो रोमन पीपल आए, यू नो, द ग्रीक, रोमन, इवन द इवन इफ आई हैव टू डेट बैक इन टाइम, सो आई टॉक अबाउट द मेसोपोटामिया एंड द इजिप्ट. तो इजिप्शियन सिविलाइजेशन भी जो थी, उन्होंने पिरामिड्स बनाए, एंड दीज पिरामिड्स इवेंचुअली दे इंक्लाइन विद द बेल्ट ऑफ ओरायन. तो आप में से काफ़ी कम लोगों को पता होगा, बट ये जो तीन स्टार्स होते हैं इन द बेल्ट ऑफ ओरायन, तो वो तीन स्टार्स जो होते हैं वो तीन पिरामिड के साथ कोइंसाइड करते हैं. तो दैट इज लाइक द काइंड ऑफ साइंस दैट वी वर हैविंग इन लाइक ऑलमोस्ट 8,000 ईयर्स अगो, एंशियंट टाइम. सो यू नो, साइंस इज समथिंग लाइक दैट यू कैन नॉट सेग्रीगेट विद पीपल, दैट यू कैन नॉट, उसे आप अलग कर ही नहीं सकते, यू कैन नॉट बायफर्केटेड बाय एनी मीन्स. तो जब तक इंसान रहेगा, तब तक एग्जैक्ट साइंस रहेगा जब से इंसान आया है इस पृथ्वी पे, ऑलमोस्ट लाइक ये बिलियन ऑफ इयर्स अगो. हां, साइंस हैज बीन देयर एंड साइंस वुड ऑलवेज बी देयर, सो इट इज अ गुड थीम, पीपल फॉर साइंस एंड साइंस फॉर पीपल.
तो सर, क्या आप ये कहना चाह रहे हैं कि आज का जो यूथ है वो घर के अंदर तक ही सीमित रह गया है, लाइक दे आर कॉन्स्टेंटली दे आर प्लेइंग दैट गेम PUBG, ब्लू व्हेल एंड व्हाट नॉट, तो क्या वो क्योंकि बाहर नहीं जा रहा है, नेचर ऑब्जर्व नहीं कर रहा, तो क्या उनकी क्यूरियोसिटी अंदर जो है वो कम हो रही है या दब रही है?
I would not completely agree with this. Mm-hmm. To an extent it is correct. But I would say ki even if you are using YouTube, mm-hmm. YouTube is a very good source ki jahan pe aap bahut sari cheeze dekh sakte ho. Theek hai, initially when we used to go outside and play, we mm-hmm. were not having the source ki ye kya ho raha hai, hame pata nahi hai. We see a cocoon and we cannot actually rectify what is going on along with that. तो आज के जमाने में, आज के समय में हमारे पास ये साधन हो चुका है दैट सिंस वी आर इन द 4.0 इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन, तो हमारे पास इंटरनेट इज एट द फिंगर टिप्स एंड जियो हैज एंड सो मेनी अदर दीज ऑपरेटर्स हैव कम आउट विद सच अ गुड स्पीड ऑफ इंटरनेट कि हमें कोई भी क्यूरियोसिटी है तो हम वापस घर पे जाएं और हम देखें, वहां पे यूट्यूब खोलें एंड वी हैव टू जस्ट टाइप इन दैट व्हाट इज अ कोकून एंड यू वुड गेट ऑल द आंसर्स. सो बेसिकली द नॉलेज इज राइट एट योर डिस्पोजल. इनिशियली यू हैड टू सर्च फॉर द पीपल, यू हैड टू गो अराउंड एंड सर्च फॉर समवन जो आपको वो सारी चीजें बता सके. करंटली इवन द लिटिल वंस, द प्री एलिमेंट्री स्कूल किड्स, दे नो हाउ टू यूज यूट्यूब, दे नो हाउ टू यूज द बेटर वेबसाइट्स आउट देयर, सो दे कैन जस्ट गो एंड मेक देयर वे थ्रू द गूगल, दे कैन कम अक्रॉस दीस थिंग्स. बट या डेफिनेटली द फर्स्ट प्रीरिक्विजिट दैट आई वुड से इज दैट यू नीड टू क्वेश्चन, सो क्वेश्चनिंग समवन इज लाइक रियली एसेंशियल.
ओके सर, लाइक साइंस इज इवॉल्व एवरीवेयर, लाइक हमारी डेली लाइफ में हम कुछ भी करें, छोटी से छोटी एक्टिविटी में साइंस होता है. सो हाउ डू यू ऑब्जर्व साइंस डे, लाइक हाउ मच नेसेसरी इट इज़ फॉर एन इंस्टीट्यूशन टू एनकरेज स्टूडेंट टू सेलिब्रेट दिस डे और टू कम अप विद न्यू एक्टिविटीज?
See, irrespective of what institution you are, does not matter. Even you are, if you are from arts or you are from humanities, you are from commerce or you are from math science. What I believe is that science is something that is there in every aspect of your life. Right from like spinning, weaving and everything. You know, the newspaper that you read comes out of science. The machines that you read comes out of science. The newspapers and everything around you that you see in the world. Even the cybernet, the internet, everything is a discovery of science. So basically, science has been so deep rooted into our lives that we cannot just remove science by any other means. So you know, science is something that is there within the very fabric of the society that we live in. So as the institution, irrespective of what the basic course or the genre of the subject is, you need to provide them with a basic framework so that the science can nourish in the minds of the students. And eventually concomitantly you have to work into a stream ki zyada se zyada log, bhale koi bhi institution mein ho, aapko ek basic idea or ek basic framework provide karwana is very necessary, very essential.
Okay. So sir, aapne cyber science ki baat kari, to aajkal sir this is a very hot topic these days ki साइबर क्राइम्स बहुत हो रहे हैं, पीपल आर शेयरिंग देयर डेटा, उनको पता नहीं होता बेसिकली, बट देन वो कुछ भी अगर शेयर करते हैं तो सम ऑफ द अदर वे उनका कॉन्फिडेंशियल डेटा शेयर हो जाता है. So would you like to suggest something to our listeners?
Well, yeah, this has been a hot topic from like past so many years. We have came across ki yadi hum apne aadhar card ko de denge, hum seat karwa lenge, we give like hum apne pan card ko attach karwa lenge, so our data would leak somehow or somewhere. So now even the government has been coming out with so many policies and strategies to protect our data. So data in this world in 21st century is something like really vulnerable to be protected from hackers and ethical hackers. So you know, we are like on the brim of danger. Jaise this query would bring me back to the first query that Shruti asked me, that ki people question is science is a boon or a bane.
Yes.
Exactly. So I would just revert back to that, because you know, again, cyber security ka ye ek negative impact hai, that whatever data you are giving out is like really vulnerable. So we are living in the world of 21st century where the hackers are like really potent, but eventually we even have a good security network and good security protocol. So we have come out with so many national security, cyber security cells, which are like always working for the betterment of the people, for the betterment and the security and safety of our data. So even the government is trying to come out with a cyber security data book, the complete book, which will record all the data, and those would be the data which are not encrypted or like way too personal. So hame us baat mein chinta lene ki koi zarurat nahi hai, hame chinta karne ki koi avashyakta nahi hai, because hamara jo data hai wo more or less protect rahega. And the cyber security is definitely a field of a stream jahan pe government is working like untiredly, and it is working like day ahead and day again, because cyber security is must. And you know, after since the judgment of right to privacy by Supreme Court, cyber security has become more of a part of our lives. So the government is taking precise steps, and in time to come it would do so, and there would be no need for all of us to actually frighten. So,
okay, so you're telling our listeners not to worry.
Not to worry about anything, exactly.
Okay. So, sir, apart from this, I would like to ask you, do you like listening music, listening
to
songs?
I do very much,
So, aapko Arijit Singh ki voice pasand hai?
I love him.
तो हमारे रिदम में भी एक ऐसे कलाकार मौजूद हैं जिन्हें हम रिदम के अरिजीत सिंह के नाम से जानते हैं। ओके, तो आइए लेते हैं यहाँ पे एक छोटा सा ब्रेक और सुनवाती हूँ मैं आपको रिदम के अरिजीत सिंह प्रियांश जैन की मखमली सी आवाज में एक प्यारा सा गाना, और गाने का नाम है देखा हजारों
दफा। अकॉर्डिंग टू डार्विन की हम
गाइज, आप सुन रहे हैं BSSS रिदम, दी ऑनलाइन इंटरनेशनल रेडियो स्टेशन। और जैसा कि आप जानते हैं कि आज है 28th of February, यानी कि नेशनल साइंस डे। और क्योंकि भाई स्टार्टिंग में ही मैं बता चुकी हूँ कि आज का शो बहुत स्पेशल है, और आज मेरे साथ है यहाँ पे मिस्टर संयम श्रीवास्तव जी। तो आइए इनसे बात हम आगे बढ़ाते हैं। सर, व्हाट अकॉर्डिंग टू यू इज द बेस्ट गोल अ पर्सन शुड हैव इन साइंस, इन साइंस स्ट्रीम?
See, there's no one specific way for a specific person. All of us are different. You know, that is unity lies in diversity, isn't it? तो हम लोगों का evolution भी ऐसे हुआ है according to Darwin कि हम सब अलग-अलग तरीके से evolve हुए हैं. The Latin American people are different from what the Indians are different from what the people of the Central Asia are. So well, basically to impose a single specific viewpoint on someone would be like quite biased, and that would go even with the eventually with the people, because if I tell you people about my what I had to pursue as a career, I wanted to be an astronomer always, but my parents always wanted me to be an engineer. So you know, I was pathetic in engineering, and after that after all the struggles and everything, I came to the realization, dawned upon me that astronomy was something that I really wanted to pursue ever since, and this would be the career that I would rather choose. So I would say ki let the people choose whatever they want to choose, because science is no particular one field. If you want to get into astronomy, get into astronomy. Do not give it a second thought. Do not come under the peer pressure or the pressure of your parents. Or do not think about the security point of view, because once you are into it, you would come out with the flying colors, and that is sure to happen.
Okay.
So, whatever you like.
So, you are trying to say that हमें जिस field में interest है, जिस particular field में हम जाना चाहते हैं, हम वही करें.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes, ये भी बिल्कुल सही है, because आज का जो youth है वो काफी artistic है. They are more towards
arts and literature.
Yes.
तो
सर, जैसा कि मैंने पहले भी कहा कि साइंस इज इनटू एवरीथिंग, और इसी चीज से क्वेश्चन मेरे दिमाग में आ रहा है, आई गेस हमारे सारे लिसनर्स भी यही जानना चाह रहे होंगे, सोच रहे होंगे कि साइंस इज एवरीवेयर, लाइक बी इट टेक्नोलॉजी, बी इट आर्किटेक्ट, एंड इवन इन मार्केटिंग और मैनेजमेंट, इट इज इंक्रीजिंग वेरी रैपिडली. So how do you see science in 2050?
Science in 2050 would be kind of like something spectacular. Yadi main aaj ke date mein bataun to China ne recently ek mission bheja hai back side of the moon pe, jo aaj tak kisi country ne nahi bheja after USSR, the Soviet Union, in the erstwhile Russia. Ye jo pehla rover hai, that is better named as the Chang'e 4. So that would be landing on the far side of the moon, better telling us the potent ki wahan pe kya kya cheeze hain. And aane wale time mein hum ye mante hain ki hamare jo rockets honge wo helium 3 pe work karenge, and helium 3 has not been found anywhere on the planet of earth. So probably ek to earth pe itna zyada overcrowding ho raha hai that you see the population is ever increasing. So you know, we are seeking for the alternative sources of getting somewhere to different planets to actually colonize over there, just the way that British colonized someday in the past in India, almost in 1757, right after the Battle of Plassey. So well, we are searching forward for the reserves, and there is resources like the helium 3 and elsewhere, yeah. which is not available on the Earth. So NASA is also coming out with some certain projects to send the man on the Mars for the first time. And eventually even India is coming out with the plan first time for in the history of India in the year 2022 under the able guidance of the Prime Minister. We are actually coming out with a project to send the man for the first time in space. Right from India. So the mission is known as Gaganyaan and we are working on that. So what I see signs almost down the line is that we people would be like somewhere also utilizing the resources on other planets. We would have known the signs in the way that we could have like actually came out with the process to actually tackle dangerous diseases like the cancer. You know, ever since the 1920s, the discovery of penicillin, I would say that was the time that the field of medicine came into the prominence. The field of the biology came into prominence. So well, right after the discovery of penicillin by Alexander Fleming, we have come a long way down the line that we are even doing the genetic editing. We have even came out with something like genome, the global genome. So well, gene editing, aap sabhi ne agar newspaper ko follow kiya to you would have come across the gene editing jo China ke ek vaigyanik ne ki thi. To ab aap dekhe ki hum insaan ke andar bhi badlav kar sakte. We can actually go into the deoxyribonucleic acid, the DNA, and we can change all the generations to come. So in short, the evolution is lying within us. The evolution is under our control. So that can go against the ethical norms. But I definitely see science progressing to a tremendous amount. And usse precisely bata pana, it is since a subjective discussion, not an objective one. So I cannot say there would be objective, a single answer to that. But yeah, subjectively, I do see science unfolding into the ways that we cannot even imagine.
Okay. So you are telling ki time, jaise jaise aage badega, waise waise hum Earth ki to resources use kar hi payenge, saath mein स्पेस अदर प्लैनेट्स की भी यूज कर पाएंगे. Okay, wonderful. So there is one more hot topic these days, and that is nanotechnology, right? Which is highly snapping the ranges of science and engineering discipline. It is widely used, like what we people know, it is widely used in medicine, even in military, even in beauty products like sunscreens or lipsticks, etc. So how do you, like what you want to tell to our listeners about this nanotechnology?
Nanotechnology, just like all the other disciplines that we have talked about so far, like the cybersecurity and so on and so forth, is the technology that we have to actually get into the minute level, the, you know, the most micro kind of level that is possible. And nanotechnology is a discipline that has the, I would say, the outlet in all the possible fields that we can imagine about, as you have said, Shruti. It ranges right from the engineering discipline to the technology and even to the space sciences. So in time to come, we are also trying to work on the ranges of bands, you know, in the space science, in the especially the field of aeronautics and avionics, we are coming out with the Ka and the Ku bands. So that would require a potent source of nanotechnology. And what I see currently as of now is that nanotechnology in time to come would just increase, if not stay stagnant. So it is also a good potent, I would say, a career option for the people who want to pursue it. And even India has come out with a nanotechnological center for the youth. And that would also provide you an outlet. And we are also outsourcing the international collaborations. So we are having the collaborations with the international university in France and Yale and elsewhere. So for people who want to actually see nanotechnology as a career, is a good option, a really good one.
Where is that center in India?
Well, I'm not concerned about that as of now, so I won't comment upon that.
Okay. Yeah. So there is one more thing, and that is artificial intelligence. Like scientists are with their full efforts, they are working कि रोबोट्स जो हैं वो ह्यूमन बिहेवियर को अडैप्ट करें और ह्यूमन थिंकिंग के हिसाब से काम करें. सो हाउ इज दिस बेनिफिशियल फॉर आवर सोसाइटी?
सी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल मैं अपने ऑडियंस को बताना चाहूँगा कि ये जो टेक्नोलॉजिकल इनोवेशन हो रहा है, ये स्टार्ट हुआ है 1760 में, एंड दैट वॉज द इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन वन, जो ब्रिटिश ने स्टार्ट किया था राइट फ्रॉम द लैंकाशायर एंड द मैनचेस्टर, एंड दैट डिसेंडेड डाउन टू द एंटायर वर्ल्ड. एंड एज वी सी दैट फ्रॉम ब्रिटेन इट वेंट ऑन टू जर्मनी, द फ्रांस, एंड फ्रॉम दैट वेंट टू द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका. इंडिया में काफी लेट आई है स्टीमिंग मशीन एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट. तो इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन वन से स्टार्ट होते होते वी हैड फोर इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन, एंड द फोर्थ वन वी आर एक्चुअली लिविंग. सो द फोर्थ वन स्टार्टेड इन द ईयर ऑफ 2000 विद द information technology. So IT was the thing that you all people know that aaj jitne youth employed hai sabse zyada wo IT firms mein employed hai. So you know, IT has come out with a greater scope for India, and India ke jo development thi kafi multifold ho gayi right with the coming of IT technology, and that was the start of industrial revolution 4.0. So in this industrial revolution itself, simultaneously we are coming out with with the technologies of artificial intelligence and the Internet of Things. So artificial intelligence would be one of the best possible technique that we have came out with. It can like हमारा जो काम होगा वो काफी हद तक वो decrease हो जाएगा. अभी भी अगर हम देखें काफी सारे लोगों को ये feel आता है since you have seen the movies Robert One and Robert this Two Point Two. So well people think कि robotics would be a field जो हमारे लिए काफी disastrous होगी. But if I tell you today, scientists still work in the field of robotics, like they have worked in the field of robotics from quite some time. तो यदि आप industries में जाके देखें, factories में जाके देखें, तो जितना भी assembling होता है, जितना भी supply chain में mechanism होता है, वो पूरा robotics से होता है. All the assembly line that goes into the making of an automobile is basically robotics. Okay. But what we are concerned over at this point of time is that कि हम artificial intelligence में human-like traits कैसे लेके आए? And इसका सबसे अच्छा example था अभी जो हमने एक robot देखा था, humanoid kind of a robot that was better named as Sophia. So we all came across Sophia. तो ये वापस हम अपने पहले question पे जाते हैं that science is a boon or a bane. So well, people had this apprehension कि अब Sophia के आने के बाद अगर ये लोगों ने हमें overtake कर लिया तो क्या होगा? But you know, since we are in the process.
सांस ली तूने सर.
अटक क्यों रहा है? नेट धीरे चल रहा है. बंद हो गया बहन छोड़.
एक रोबोट देखा था, ह्यूमनॉइड काइंड ऑफ रोबोट दैट वाज बेटर नेम्ड एज सोफिया. सो वी ऑल केम अक्रॉस सोफिया. तो ये वापस हम अपने पहले क्वेश्चन पे जाते हैं दैट साइंस इज अ बून और अ बेन. सो वेल पीपल हैड दिस अप्रिहेंशन कि अब सोफिया के आने के बाद अगर ये लोगों ने हमें ओवरटेक कर लिया तो क्या होगा. बट यू नो सिंस वी आर इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ क्रिएटिंग दोज रोबोट्स, वी ऑल हैव द टेक्नोलॉजी, वी ऑल हैव द मेथड एंड द एल्गोरिथम टू एक्चुअली मेक वन. सो वी वुड ऑल्सो बी कमिंग आउट विद एन एल्गोरिथम to actually disassemble one or to actually deactivate one. So it is something like we know that what we are working on. See, potent use sabka hai and there is also a danger associated with that, just the way that we were talking about the nuclear bombs, the atom bombs. So in the same vein, I would say that if we come out with the better technology, artificial intelligence, it would be for the betterment of people and not to like raid us in all possible senses. So we would also come out with enough safeguards.
सर मैं आपसे लाइक मैंने आपकी प्रोफाइल जो रीड करी थी उसमें मैंने आपके बारे में ये जाना था कि यू हैव वर्क्ड विद द बिगेस्ट एस्ट्रोनॉमिकल मैगजीन राइट कॉल्ड द स्टार.
यस
तो हाउ वाज योर एक्सपीरियंस देयर लाइक वर्किंग विद दैट.
वेल द डायरेक्टर इन दोस टाइम्स वर मिस्टर डेविड द सीनियर साइंटिस्ट एंड आई वाज लाइक रियली इलेटेड एंड आई वाज लकी इनफ टू एक्चुअली वर्क अंडर हिम. So that was the kind of experience that all of us would actually like to get into in detail. Because when I was there, I came across various scientists, many scientists all over America and Europe. So we actually met in delegations and many exchange of ideas. I got to learn more. I got a bigger exposure and I came across the people who were the pioneers in my field. So to put it in a nutshell, I would say it was an amazing experience and the kind of experience which was worthwhile for a life.
Okay. Yeah. तो सर लाइक अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क यू कि आपको और कौन कौन सी फील्ड्स में इंटरेस्ट है, लाइक आपकी हॉबीज क्या हैं?
वेल इफ आई से अबाउट माय हॉबीज अपार्ट फ्रॉम एस्ट्रोनॉमी एंड एस्ट्रोफिजिक्स, आई हैव बीन एन एविड स्टूडेंट, काइंड ऑफ बोरिंग, आई हैड बीन अ बुकवर्म, टू बी लाइक वेरी प्रिसाइज इन दैट सेंस. एंड वेल आई लाइक हिस्ट्री वेरी मच एंड आई वोंट टॉक अबाउट द डिसिप्लिन्स, आई लाइक नियरली ऑल द डिसिप्लिन्स राइट फ्रॉम द फिलॉसफी एंड द रेन डिस्कार्ड्स ऑन टू द हिस्ट्री एंड वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री एंड एवरीथिंग दैट यू कैन एक्चुअली परसीव. सो आई हैव also been a student of law and I have also done my engineering. But if I just blatantly talk about my hobbies, so I watch Netflix very much, and apart from that I have also been into much novels. By the way, Dan Brown is the kind of person whom I have like desperately followed through and through. And apart from reading, and I also write sometimes, so I have had the jottings elsewhere and they were like quite popularized on the Instagram. And I also like to play football, and wildlife have been something like that had been been I had been into like through and through.
Okay.
So tracking wildlife and adventure is something that has been keeping me on the drive. Yeah. Thank you.
तो सर आप यहाँ पे आज हमारे साथ हैं, मैं जानना चाहूंगी कि आपको हमारा कॉलेज का जो कैंपस है वो कैसा लगा?
टू से अबाउट द भोपाल स्कूल ऑफ सोशल साइंसेज, आई वुड जस्ट से दैट यू नो दिस इज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट मेंटेन्ड कॉलेज राइट हियर इन द स्टेट ऑफ सेंट्रल इंडिया. आई हैव बीन टू सो मेनी इंस्टीट्यूशंस, आई हैव बीन टू लाइक सो मेनी सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटीज, बट देन कमिंग ओवर हियर आई एक्चुअली केम अक्रॉस दैट यू पीपल आर नॉट जस्ट पुट इनटू द फील्ड ऑफ एजुकेशन बाय फोर्स. यू नो देयर आर सो मेनी डिफरेंट थिंग्स दैट यू कैन डू over here. You can do swimming, you can go around in the garden. They have so well maintained ambience. The itinerary, the faculties are also cooperative, and the things right from the canteen and even the students, you know, so all you people make a good package, and I would say it is like a complete university than that one would aspire for, the complete college that one would aspire for.
डेवलपमेंट की आपने बात कही है, अपॉर्चुनिटीज की आपने बात की, तो यहाँ मैं हमारे जो कॉलेज के प्रिंसिपल हैं डॉक्टर फादर जॉन पीजे, उन्हें थैंक यू बोलना चाहूँगी कि उन्हें उन्होंने एक इतना बड़ा प्लेटफॉर्म हमें दिया है जहाँ पे हम हमारे टैलेंट को और अच्छी तरीके से एक्सप्लोर कर सकते हैं, सीख सकते हैं. सो वन मोर थिंग, आप यहाँ आज हमारे स्टूडियो में हमारे साथ खड़े हैं, हमारे लिसनर्स से बात कर रहे हैं, तो व्हाट आर योर वाइब्स हेयर इन रिदम, लाइक BSSS रिदम?
आई एम लाइक एक्चुअली आई जस्ट केम हियर फ्रॉम राइट फ्रॉम अ लेक्चर. So, I was taking a lecture and all my energy was nearly drained and मैं काफी थका हुआ था जब यहाँ पे आया while I was driving, and then when I entered over here I was like very tired and I thought that I need a caffeine or I need a good dose of I would say coffee or espresso to actually lighten me up, and then when I came within and when I interacted with you and when I came across all of this session, I would say that I am rejuvenated, I'm enthralled, and the adrenaline is flowing within me even without the need of a caffeine. So I would say that this work miracles and this is something like really energetic. Very good.
Rhythm का जादू ही कुछ ऐसा है, सबको मानो एकदम एनर्जेटिक और जोश से भर देता है. ओके, तो सर बस यहीं मैं आपसे विदा चाहूंगी, पर चाहूंगी मैं आपसे कि आप हमारा जो यूथ है उनके लिए कुछ मैसेज देके जाएं.
बिल्कुल. सी, आई वर्क माय वे थ्रू एंड आई वाज अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ एस्ट्रोनॉमी, देन आई केम टू इंजीनियरिंग, एंड देन फाइनली आई केम इनटू द सिविल सर्विसेज. सो आई केम एंड वर्क फॉर द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. And then I would just say that do not be bewildered. आप बिल्कुल confused मत होइए whatever you are doing. Just do whatever you want to do. If you like the field of music, excel into it. If you like the field of dance, excel into it. If you like the field of astronomy, excel into it. And if you like the field of commerce, be a good banker, work in the World Bank, work in the International Monetary Fund, and work anywhere that you want to. But you need to excel. You know, do not listen to the people around you. They would always pull you down because people want to pull the others down. They cannot see someone rising up. So, you know, do not listen to whatever the people around you say. If they act as a catalyzer for you, you can work forward your way. But if they don't, just leave the people behind and do whatever enthralls your soul, whatever puts in the energy within you, whatever you love the most. So, you know, whenever you will do that, you would come out better in that field, and that field would actually be known by your name. So, you know, it's always good to be known as an astronomer, but you know, don't you feel that when someone says Stephen Hawking, people know, okay, Stephen Hawking was the guy who was into astronomy. Similarly, when we come across so many different kind of people, we say Arijit Singh. So no one has to tell you that he's a musician, right? So do something that would actually enthrall you, do something that would make the field know because of you, not the field after you.
Yes, exactly. सभी चाहते हैं कि उनका जो नाम हो एकदम टैग लाइन बन के न्यूज पेपर की. ओके, तो चलिए सर, थैंक यू सो मच
फॉर
योर प्रेजेंस.
इट वॉज फन, इट वॉज एनर्जेटिक, एंड आई लव्ड इट थ्रू एंड थ्रू.
ओके, आशा करती हूँ कि हमारे जो लिसनर्स हैं उन्हें आपसे बात करके काफी मजा आया होगा, साइंस को जान के उन्हें काफी अच्छा लगा होगा. सर ब्रेक में जैसा कि आपने मुझे बताया कि आपको क्लासिकल सुनना बहुत पसंद है, तो हमारी रिदम में एक ऐसी कलाकार है जो क्लासिकल एक्सपर्ट मानी जाती है, तो बस मैं आपको सुनाना चाहूंगी अनुजा शर्मा की आवाज में एक गाना, और गाने का नाम है आज जाने की जिद ना करो.
वेरी नाइस.
ओके, सो स्टे ट्यून्ड टू BSSS रिदम. बाय बाय.
आज जाने जिद ना करो, आज जाने की जिद ना करो, यूं ही पहले आज जाने की जिद ना करो, हाय मर जाएंगे हम तो लुट जाएंगे, ऐसी बातें किया ना करो, आज जाने की जिद ना करो, आज जाने की जिद ना करो।
इतना घटिया कॉलेज था अपना तो भैया, अपना कॉलेज से तो ऐसा झील छोटी लगती है। बीएसएसएस पर बहुत तगड़ा बनाया, बहुत प्यारा बनाया,
तो मस्ती खोलोगे,
स्विमिंग पूल है अंदर, मतलब स्विमिंग पूल म्यूजियम है अंदर,
मस्ती खोलोगे बना वो कॉलेज।
चलो हो गया।